Things like this are all too common for many people this winter, but there is a silver lining to this never-ending winter of our discontent. You can expect a lot fewer stink bugs when spring finally arrives this year, if it ever does arrive. News 8's Sally Kidd has this story from a farm in Maryland.
After suffering bad crop losses to stink bugs in recent years, the folks who run this organic farm in Maryland are just hoping researchers are right.
So in here were peppers, eggplants, hot peppers, and tomatoes.
Red Wiggler Community Farm has been waging a battle against the pesky stink bug for years.
We have found that if we plant sunflowers around the perimeter of the fields, it traps the stink bugs.
Still, every year the bugs do their damage.
We saw a lot of damage to our red tomatoes, our hybrid tomatoes, and all of our nightshades, so the eggplants, okra, and then we also had.
But this winter, with the polar vortex sending temperatures into a tailspin, there's hope.
Let's just say we're cautiously optimistic at this point in time.
Entomologists see signs that the extreme cold may have put a deadly chill on the stink bug population.
In some of the colder spots where it got to -5 Fahrenheit, we might see mortality upward of 95%.
But the University of Maryland's Michael Raup, also known as the bug guy, says the number may be closer to 50%. Stink bugs happen to be pretty cold hardy.
They prepare for winter by producing compounds very similar to the antifreeze in your car's radiator.
Those compounds help protect them from frigid temps. And Raup says that's why he's only cautiously optimistic.
It would have to be like hell freezing over, probably, to get rid of these stink bugs for good.
Well, experts say we probably won't know the full impact of the polar vortex on the stink bug population until May or early June. In Germantown, Maryland, Sally Kidd, News 8.